To truly appreciate where we are, let's start again at the very beginning. On an island on the other side of the world. On streets where a boy sat every day for hours, peddling whatever he could find for spare change, desperate to find a way out. And then he discovered a better way. It nevertheless defies belief that from that boy's forgotten corner of the map, he could reach the very top of the world. That boxing could turn a man into a miracle. It makes more sense in his case. Even if his beginning came on streets that offered hardly any more promise. The craft was a family business. A comfort with conflict was embedded in his blood. Fame and fortune in view at much closer range. But from these contrasting origins, in these early years of the 21st century, twin superstars were born. Propelled by belief in very different deities.
My name is Manny Mayweather.
Guided by sages of very different dispositions. They circled each other, as fighters tend to do. Their brilliance at once tantalizing you and testing your patience. Until, at last, you might say boxing's latest miracle arrived.
Come on, let's go.
The most beautiful truth of the sport is that it reveals everything about the men who engage in it. Their objectives, their priorities, the dreams they still harbor, regardless of what they've already achieved.
All work! All work!
This is the story of men who never relent. The tale of a fight even fate itself appeared to yearn for. And a reminder of the possibility of what can materialize in that rarest of predicaments, the convergence of the very best in the boxing ring.
And welcome to Las Vegas, Nevada. On a beautiful spring afternoon, folks, we are at the MGM Grand Hotel and Casino for what is the biggest boxing event of 2015 and perhaps of this entire generation. A fight card that has been years in the making and is now less than 1 hour from getting underway. This is Countdown Live, Mayweather versus Pacquiao, as we get you ready for the big pay-per-view headlined by Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao. The welterweight championship of the world, with the winner staking claim to the title best fighter on the planet. And hello everyone and welcome to Las Vegas. I'm James Brown, very happy to be joined here at the host desk by an all-star lineup of boxing experts. Going into the Hall of Fame next month is Jim Lampley. In the Boxing Hall of Fame already is Al Bernstein, the one and only Roy Jones Jr., and the guy who is still fighting and announcing, Paulie Malignaggi. Guys, we'll get your thoughts in just a moment about the main event, but this incredibly talented quartet with me here at the desk, just part of the overall group of broadcasters who we have assembled to bring you every angle and aspect of this spectacular affair. Also joining us this evening, Jim Gray and Max Kellerman. They'll serve as our reporters and talk with both main event fighters. Inside the ring, Michael Buffer and Jimmy Lennon Jr. will share duties as they call the marquee fighters to the arena before the main event gets underway. And we'll also have a dynamic duo scoring the fights unofficially for us. Steve Farhood and Harold Letterman will handle those duties. Well, one may ask the question, how big is this event? Well, that may be hard to quantify, but without a doubt, MAPAC has become a force of its own on social media. This fight has been debated and discussed by fans for over 5 years, making Mayweather-Pacquiao a hot-button topic for just as long. Showtime's Mauro Ranallo files this report.
Every generation has a defining fight, the kind of battle that leaves an indelible imprint on history, a primal display of courage and athleticism. It proves all men are equal. It's the perception of good versus evil on a different battlefield. The victor becomes a hero that transcends race. It's the bruiser versus the butterfly, two proud champions forcing the world to choose sides. If time creates a fighter, circumstance creates a phenomenon. Every era spawns its own heroes, the right fit for the times in which they fight. Larger than life personalities that take the sport to new heights. But with every peak, there is a valley. And for years, we've wandered the open road, seeking our fight that will live forever. At no time in human history have fans had a louder voice. And they use that voice to demand that this century's two top attractions meet in the center of the ring. After 5 long years and a chance encounter, lightning has finally struck. And now, we await the thunder. Let's get
ready to rumble! Our goal is to give the fans a good fight.
The biggest fight in boxing history. And I'm a part of it, so.
Floyd Mayweather versus Manny Pacquiao. This generation's defining fight is finally here.
Well, starting 2 weeks ago, we invited you to make your MAPAC prediction by tweeting the hashtag MayWins or PacWins. Now, millions have responded, and at present, I want Jim Lampley to take a look at these numbers. Take a look at these results.
Well, that's a lot of either upset thinking or wishful thinking, because the odds in the sports books are more than the reverse of that. Mayweather is about a 5-2 favorite at this point. But obviously, there are quite a number of fans who are responding with their hearts and saying that they want Pacquiao to win, so they believe he's going to win.
Wishful thinking?
Well, Manny Pacquiao is a popular figure, and clearly that doesn't reflect what the smart folks who are doing the odds think.
All right, well, there is still time for you to vote. As a matter of fact, all you need to do is cast your vote. We'll give you the final results later tonight before the opening bell. Back here now with my squad of guys. Now, the road to Mayweather-Pacquiao has been, some might describe it as long and winding. Let me ask the experts, would that be your description of the road to tonight's event?
Well, it was an up and down path for a period of up to 6 years. And in Mauro's piece, you saw the one moment where they bumped into each other at the Miami Heat basketball game in December or January, I forget exactly which month it was, but I believe he's correct in calling that lightning strikes. Without that bump in meeting at the basketball game, I don't think we're here.
Yeah, and the other part of this I think that's important to note is this journey taking a while and being so difficult has had an impact on the sport of boxing, because James, this is the one match that the mainstream sports media has kind of pinned has put a big mark on boxing for not making this fight. And simply by having this fight, it helps the sport.
Roy Jones, your thoughts?
Well, I think it's just a fight that, like he said, it's a fight that definitely helps the sport. And it took so long, but that long anticipation may be the reason it's gotten so big. So for us, we realize that guys sometimes do age, but when they're in the same era, age does not matter. Mm.
Yeah, and you know, I think the 5 years has built it up to the degree that now it's must-see TV. I mean, at first you had the crossover fans talking about it, but now you have almost all the crossover fans talking about it. I mean, this is, I literally think this is bigger than the World Cup. I mean, it's worth more money. Yeah, maybe they're a little past their primes and not as much in their primes as 5 years ago, but people are just as excited, if not more excited, because the fight's finally happening.
You know, Paula, you mentioned past their primes, and I know all of you guys are respected for being very honest. I look forward to later in the evening finding out whether that's going to hurt what is anticipated to be a good classic styles matchup as well, too. All right, Mayweather-Pacquiao. The fight is just around the corner as we continue our countdown to the biggest fight in recent memory. Now, the success of Floyd Mayweather is a testament to his motto of hard work and dedication. But the evolution of Floyd Mayweather began long before the brash antics, the collection of cars, the plush mansions, and the private jets. It began when a young boy with a pugilistic pedigree, that is, laced up a pair of gloves for the first time and decided never to take them off.
I fight for many different things. I fight for myself. I fight for the money. I fight for legacy. I fight because I want to be the best. I fight because I want to go down in history as one of the best. That's the reason why I fight.
When he was young, man, you can't believe what he was doing. I mean, this guy was destined to be a champion.
Raised in the gyms of Grand Rapids, Michigan by his father and his uncle Roger, Mayweather's talent was apparent at a very early age, winning his first of three Golden Gloves national titles at the age of 16.
First, I want to thank the good man upstairs for giving me this opportunity to win the national championship. And second of all, I want to thank my father.
But that celebration was short-lived, for just a few weeks later, Floyd Sr., father and trainer, was sentenced to 5 years in prison.
Everything in life happens for a reason, and that made me work hard and push myself to the limit.
With his focus tightened, Mayweather turned pro and signed with Bob Arum and Top Rank Promotions.
When I went to Top Rank, at that particular time, their whole focus was Oscar De La Hoya. So that's why we kept bumping heads.
After a decade in the shadow of De La Hoya and under the control of Bob Arum, Mayweather bought himself out of the contract, shedding the name of Pretty Boy and adopting the moniker Money.
Finally, when I got free and became my own boss, I done things my way. That's when we started doing record-breaking numbers. And that's what it's about. Money isn't everything. Money is the only thing.
Yeah, ba-bing.
Some guys you love, some guys you hate. That's what sells tickets. And I'm here to sell tickets, you know. I'm a performer, that's what I do, I sell myself.
Some people look at it as being an asshole. Some people look at it as being cocky. It was just a smart business move by a young kid from Grand Rapids.
A hero and a villain all rolled into one. But everything always comes back to boxing.
I worked my whole life to get to this point. I was destined to be where I'm at.
Statement for sure to say an impressive boxer, but Al, you were there for his fight back in 1996.
Yeah, he was just a few months removed from winning a bronze medal at the Olympic Games. And then on an outdoor stadium at Texas Station, he would have his pro debut, paid a lot less money than tonight, that's for sure. And you could tell during that fight, James, that this was a very, very excellent young fighter. This was a young man who was going to be a terrific pro. We couldn't know that he would be quite as good as he has become, but we knew he was going to be excellent.
You know, one of the reasons I'm not on Twitter a lot, because folks tell me my hairline is now at the middle of my head. Your hairline looked pretty good back then as well, too, partner.
I had a little more hair back then. I could say that.
And talk about hair, yours is still there. Look, you've seen so many great fighters as well, too. You were there for the breakout fight for Manny Pacquiao.
Well, Twitter will cost you your hair, James. But the Manny Pacquiao is different. It's easy to understand why American fans have developed a very large audience and a great interest in Floyd Mayweather, who is an American star. Manny Pacquiao is a kid from the back islands of the Philippines who managed to become a crossover pay-per-view star in the United States. How in the world did that happen? Let's take a look.
To say Manny Pacquiao emerged from humble circumstances is a vast understatement. To say he rose to great heights is an understatement as well. Put the narrative together with the electric smile, and you have a hero worshipped by hundreds of millions of fans. The most beloved fighting statesman since Muhammad Ali. For boxing purposes, the story begins when a skinny southpaw flyweight thrives in the Philippines, winning his first lineal world title before ever setting foot on American soil. His first appearance here was in 2001 as a last-minute opponent on a pay-per-view undercard in Las Vegas.
For Lisanola Ledwaba against Manny Pacquiao. I'll get it right, Pacquiao.
By the sixth round, we had his name straight, and a knockout sensation was born.
That's a TKO victory for the very impressive Manny Pacquiao.
He was so fast, he needed no deception. Double jab, straight left hand, over and over. But it wasn't until 4 years later, after a decision loss to Eric Morales, the trainer Freddie Roach convinced the Filipino star he needed to add a quality right hook. And with that new weapon, he went to a different level.
Brilliant and courageous performance by the pride of the Philippines.
In 2008, on something of a media dare, Pacquiao moved up 12 pounds to welterweight to face Oscar De La Hoya.
It's done! Manny Pacquiao has beaten Oscar De La Hoya.
That knockout victory launched Pacquiao's unlikely run through a lineup of larger stars and took him to the pound-for-pound stratosphere.
Cotto has been softened up for the kill. Now Kenny Bayless does his duty.
At the height of his popularity, he was elected to Congress in the Philippines.
Do hereby solemnly swear.
Broadening his identity in a way his origins would never have predicted. Over time, his commitment has proven serious, substantial, and enduring. But through it all, something very significant was missing from Manny Pacquiao's storied life and career. Floyd Mayweather. Until tonight.
An impressive young man. Talk about a route indeed. Is that unprecedented from the fighters you've seen as well, too, what he has become?
This is the only sport where somebody can come from absolutely nowhere to the top of the world. He has done that to a certain degree. Floyd has done the same thing.
No question about that. Al, you've watched both fighters their entire career. Break down what you expect to see happen.
You know, when these two fighters are about as different outside the ring as they could possibly be, and inside as well. And when you have two very different styles, it makes putting together the keys to victory very intriguing. And that was the case for this fight.
Floyd Mayweather's superb boxing style is all about nuance and adaptation. And yet, ironically, his keys to victory remain constant for most fights. Mayweather can fight very well off the ropes, but that's the only place he's vulnerable, so he's better off in center ring. Floyd does not want a frenetic pace like his first fight with Marcos Maidana. The right hand is the staple of Mayweather's attack, and he delivers it with frightening accuracy. He often uses a feint with his left to set up the right hand. Using a feint with his left, Mayweather gets the right in, and especially against lefties, he almost always scoots to his right to avoid a counter left hand, the kind that southpaw Pacquiao throws extremely well. In Manny Pacquiao's great career, he was first a dedicated power puncher and then a boxer puncher with power. He's looking for the latter in this mega fight. To win this fight, Pacquiao needs to overwhelm Mayweather with activity. If he attacks in a straight line, he'll be nailed with counter right hands. Pacquiao's left hand is quick and powerful, and it could be very effective in this fight. Even when an opponent is moving, Pacquiao can land the left at just the right time. He unloads it with power and accuracy, and he'll need this to be effective against Mayweather.
Insightful information there as we thank Al Bernstein for his Hall of Fame insight into our upcoming main event for the welterweight championship of the world. And folks, we are pleased now back here at the host desk to welcome another Hall of Famer, the former undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, Mr. Lennox Lewis. Lennox, thanks for joining us as well, too.
Hey, glad to be here.
Give me your thoughts about this main event. How do you see it breaking down from your eyes?
From my point of view, I think Manny Pacquiao has to start off fast, and he has to have a constructive offense in the sense that he can't rush in too fast. So it has to be controlled aggression, getting in there, making sure that when he comes out of these punches, that he comes out clean and not get hit.
Why does he have to start off fast?
I believe that if you lay back and allow Floyd to conduct the pace of the fight, then it's his fight. So you gotta bring him out of his comfort zone and make him do things that he's not used to.
Paulie Malignaggi, your thoughts?
Well, going along those lines, I do believe Manny has to start fast. I don't think you can have a patient fight and allow Mayweather to kind of break you down and dictate the terms of the pace of the fight. Having said that, if you're going to start fast, you need to be effective because it's a double-edged sword. I remember an opponent named Jesus Chavez who fought Floyd Mayweather during his first title reign at 130 pounds. Came out in their fight throwing 100 punches a round for the first three rounds, but he wasn't that effective. He might have won the two of the first three just on based on activity, but he didn't do enough damage to Floyd. And in the end, he ended up stopped in the ninth round because he just didn't have enough. He punched himself out. So it's a double-edged sword. You got to be busy. You got to start fast, but you got to be effective.
Talk about quickness personified. That certainly explains and describes Roy Jones. Your thoughts?
Well, I think he has to start fast too, JB. But the thing about him starting fast is he has to be effective. And he has to also work the body. He can't just go to the head because if he's tired in the late rounds, by working the body, he'll have Floyd a little tired too. If he doesn't go to the body, then he'll use all that energy trying to hit Floyd. And if he's not able to hit him like he wants to, Floyd is going to be fresh in rounds 8 through 12. That's not where you want to be.
Al B?
Yeah, you know, one of the things Freddie Roach talked to us about at the fighter meeting was that their plan, their hope is that Manny Pacquiao can come in, throw a couple combinations, throw some punches, and then move. They feel like people stay at the dance too long with Mayweather. When they pressure him, that's why they get hit with those counter punches. We'll see if Pacquiao can do that.
You know, listening to Roy Jones talk about getting to the body, again, for a lot of the casual fans who will be watching this big event, can Pacquiao get to the body of Floyd, who is so quick, so elusive, a great defensive fighter?
But Pacquiao is a great fighter as well, and he's quick on his feet, and he has great reflexes. So when, you know, Floyd thinks he's got him with two punches, you know, Pacquiao can come back with three punches. So he's got real quick hands as well.
With an event this big, certainly the most desired hope is that it will live up to its expectations. You know, you talked about, is it 5 years too late? Do we still have the opportunity to see a fight match up to all of the hype, Paulie?
Well, is it 5 years too late is a good question, but at the same time, these are still two guys at the top of the sport, so it gives it a great chance to still live up to the hype. They're still very, very much at the top of the sport, better than most of the welterweights in the world, if not the two best welterweights still.
Roy, your thoughts about that?
I think the same thing. However, when you put two great basketball players against one another, whether one being old or both being the same age, if they're in that same era, you're going to get the same fireworks no matter where they come from, who they are, or what they're doing.
Boy, go ahead,
yeah.
Al. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, I would say let's look back at when Muhammad Ali first fought Joe Frazier. It was fought at a ridiculously high skill level, and it was a very exciting fight. But when they fought years later in the Thrill of Manila, maybe not at the same skill level, but a more exciting fight. Oftentimes when fighters are older, it's more exciting.
Listen, when me and Tyson got together, we were supposed to get together in the early times.
Right.
And then we left it when it was later, and everybody said, well, Tyson isn't the same. Well, I'm not the same. We both aged at the same time. Mm.
You know what David Dinkins says to move along, but when a big fella hits you on the leg and say, I got something to say, I'm going to listen to what you have to say. All right. Hey, fellas, thank you so very much. We look forward to your collective insight as we move towards the main event. All right, folks, we're just a few minutes away from the big pay-per-view, Floyd Mayweather versus Manny Pacquiao. Fight time is nearly here. But right now, let's take a final look at how we got to this moment and what it would mean to the history of the sport of boxing.
That drumbeat you hear building in the background is fans' expectations of Manny Pacquiao going against Floyd Mayweather.
If you look at boxing history, when two guys can make the kind of money that these guys are going to make, the fights usually get made. So my question was, why did it take so long?
We've come close on occasion before, very close. Sometimes it was money, sometimes it was drug testing, sometimes their training schedules didn't work out.
You're talking about the two biggest athletes in their sport for years and years and years, and they weren't able to come to terms.
So ultimately, after all these years of this dragging on, it was up to the fighters to make this fight happen.
It seems as though the breakthrough moment was
the two fighters spontaneously and serendipitously running into each other at a basketball game.